The problem with Indian engineering colleges, except for a few prestigious ones, is that all the programming classes are theoretical, where the professor just writes on the board what's written in the textbook without explaining us why. When we were students, we had so many doubts. Ki Java seekhe ya C sharp? What are the other programming languages? Where are they used? What is the market demand? 9 years back, when I started my IT career, I had the same confusion, which is why I'm making this video today. Because I don't want you to waste the initial years of your career doing something you don't like. So boys and girls, if programming is your true love, then today by the end of this video, I'll tell you which programming language will get you respect, satisfaction, and a lot of money. So in today's video, we're going to list down the top 5 programming languages of 2019. Analyze them based on 3 parameters. What is that language used for? How easy is it to learn it? And how much salary can you expect after learning that language? But most importantly, towards the end, I'll give you a bonus tip so that when you apply for a job in that programming language, your resume stands out from the rest of the crowd. But before we get started, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button because that motivates me to make more videos. Let's begin. On number 5, we have C Sharp. As you know, C Sharp is Microsoft's baby for building applications on the .NET framework. It is a pretty powerful language that is used for different tasks like designing web forms, developing web applications, Windows applications, console applications. C Sharp is also used to develop games using the Unity game engine. Coming to ease of learning, as a beginner, C Sharp is moderately easy to learn, say 3 to 4 months to learn the basics and around 2 years to become a fairly competent developer. But if you're already familiar with C++ and Java, then learning C Sharp will be like. Coming to salary, as a .NET developer, you can apply to Microsoft and also service-based companies like Infosys, TCS, CTS, because they use C Sharp as a part of enterprise solutions for their clients. So the average salary a .NET developer can expect in India is around 5 to 6 lakhs per annum. Moving away from Microsoft, next we have Swift, which is a language used for developing apps for macOS, iOS, watchOS. The reason why Swift is number 4 is because it's becoming one of the favorites of software developers. It is easier to read, easier to maintain. It is faster, safer, and requires less lines of code. So if you're an Apple fan and want to code for the future, then Swift is for you. Swift was designed to reduce the gap between the human mind and computer operations, which is why syntax-wise, Swift is pretty simple. Some say that you'll just take around 3 to 4 months to start building apps with Swift. Coming to salary, currently there's a lot of demand for developers, especially from startups who can quickly build apps using Swift. Your salary can range anywhere between 3.9 to 9.2 lakhs per annum. On number 3, we have Java. And do I even need to tell you why? The most common programming language in the world, well-paying jobs and great community support. Java is so versatile that it can be used to develop almost anything. Games, Android apps, web apps, IoT, cloud development, and the list goes on and on. Indirectly, you use Java every day. When you log on to Facebook.com, Amazon.com, eBay, LinkedIn, the creators of Java were strongly influenced by C++. So if you know your OOPS concepts, then Java is pretty easy to learn. But if you're absolutely new to programming, then you might take around 3 to 6 months to learn the basics of Java. But the good news is the community support is top-notch. So as a beginner, you'll find a lot of help online. The salary you can expect depends on your experience, the company, whether it is product-based or service-based, and can range anywhere between 4 lakhs to 12 lakhs per annum. Number 2 is Python, which has been around for more than 25 years and is not in the mood to go anywhere. Even though it started as a scripting language, but now it is a general-purpose programming language, which means that it can be used for almost anything. Web development, game development, computer vision, which involves face recognition and color detection, but most importantly, data science. Working with Python is a dream because it is readable, maintainable, and compatible with major platforms and systems. Python is like air. It's everywhere, but you can't see it. I was going to say God, but we are inclusive of all faiths or none. Netflix recommending you stuff to watch, that's Python. Amazon recommending you stuff to buy, that's also Python. Because Python is so heavy on data science and machine learning, it is used by Google, YouTube, and even the New York Stock Exchange. coming to ease of learning. Python as a language in terms of syntax and basics is pretty easy to learn. But then again, using Python to design algorithms that solve complex problems depends on your experience. The starting salary of a Python developer is around 3 lakhs and can go up to 14 lakhs per annum depending on how good you are. Now, before I tell you the number one programming language, here are three special mentions that didn't make it to the list but are pretty important. Special mention number one, C++. See, I knew it. If I wouldn't have said it, you would have come after my throat. Where is C, C++, Bulge? Yes, C is the foundation language, and C++ that was built on top of C is a very versatile language. C++, if you master it, provides you with speed enhancing and optimization techniques, which improve the performance. Which is why it is used in everything from software development to gaming, desktop apps. Even applications like Adobe Premiere, Illustrator, Photoshop are scripted in C++. Even though it is slightly difficult to learn, making it your first language has two advantages. Number one, you get introduced to the fundamental computer science concepts like heaps, stacks, pointers, memory management, etc. very early. And number two, if you start with C++, then learning other languages like Java, C# is going to be pretty easy. Special mention number two, SQL. Now, SQL is not a programming language, but it is a language for data manipulation. In real world, you will have to deal with a lot of data. You can use C++, C#, Java for coding your functionality. But in the back end, you will need SQL for retrieving data, inserting records, deleting records, creating databases, granting permission. So don't learn SQL as your first language, but learn it. Special mention number three, Flutter. These days, Flutter is making a lot of headlines in the mobile development space. And yes, it is not a programming language. Wait, I'm coming to that. Flutter is a mobile app SDK. And what makes it so desirable is that it allows you to write an app in one code base and compile to both Android and iOS. And it is the primary method for developing apps for Google Fuchsia. Did I pronounce that right? And the programming language for Flutter SDK is called Dart. So if you're up for it, go and learn Flutter and Dart, because even though they're relatively new and not that stable, they've still been adopted by Alibaba, Google Ads, and many more. And currently, a lot of startups are looking for Flutter developers. Now that we are done with our three special mentions, now is the time for the number one programming language of our list today. Four programming languages 2019 by the Urban Fight for today is...
I hate it when they do that.
JavaScript! Before we begin, Java and JavaScript are poles apart. JavaScript is a programming language for sure, but it was invented to make web pages come alive. Instead of having a web page that just sits there and does nothing, thanks to JavaScript, a web page can now react to user actions, ask questions to visitors, change the contents of the existing HTML page, make things run on mouse clicks and pointer movements. Basically, it makes a web page dynamic. When your Facebook timeline updates on your screen or Google suggests search terms based on a few characters that you type in the search box, that's JavaScript in action. Now, JavaScript is a client-side programming language, which means that as a developer, you can start coding on the browser itself without having to set up a development environment. But the reason why JavaScript is number one on our list today is because over the last few years, there has been mad development in the JavaScript language. For example, number one, the JavaScript's JSON file format is now one of the popular ways of transferring data. Number two, initially JavaScript was just client-side, but now Node.js, which is the JavaScript runtime environment, allows you to build servers using JavaScript. Number three, AngularJS, which is an MVC framework developed by Google that allows you to create crazy interactive web applications because it extends HTML with new attributes. In fact, the modern one-page Gmail application has been developed using AngularJS and a couple of other JS frameworks. And then we have React, which is the JavaScript library developed by Facebook. And the list goes on. Another reason why JavaScript is number one is because it's pretty easy to learn. You might take just around 1 to 2 months. But along with that, add JSON, Node.js, Angular, React to your skill set as well. Because if you are a front-end developer with just JavaScript as your skill, then you will earn between 3 to 6 lakhs per annum. But if you are an end-to-end JavaScript developer with all of these skill sets, then you can earn somewhere between 6 to 15 lakhs per annum. Because startups are really looking for developers who can quickly roll out a functionality by just writing a few lines of code. Now, before you leave, here's your first assignment. comment below the code for printing Hello World in the language that you love the most. For example, suppose it's JavaScript, then you will write something like this. Don't worry about errors or bugs, just write, because that is how you will start learning that language. I'll be waiting to read your comments. Now, before I give you the bonus tip to master any programming language, if this is the first video of mine you're watching, then make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon, because I make career and finance videos just for you. After you pick your favorite language and master the basics, if you want to take your coding skills to the next level, then you need to practice problem solving. Go to websites like HackerRank, LeetCode, InterviewBit, and practice solving problems. Just so that we are clear, this video is not sponsored. So if you choose InterviewBit, then they have a step-by-step plan for you to solve easy problems first and then move on to complicated ones, along with having tutorials. You can even jump to a level, pick a problem, choose the programming language you want to solve it in, and start coding. The more problems you solve, the more points you get. And then you can mention these points or rank in your resume to show the interviewer how interested you are in that programming language. But remember, don't pick a programming language because it pays a lot. Everybody starts with a low salary. But to get to the top, you really need to be good at it. So pick a programming language that drives you, not what buys you a BMW. On that note, I promise to see you again next week. Until then, keep fighting the urban fight to be fit.